On the occasion corresponding to this 4 years ago, all thoughts were anxiously directed on an impending Civil War. While the inaugural address was being delivered from this place, devoted altogether to saving the Union without war, insurgent agents were in the city seeking to destroy it without war, seeking to dissolve the Union and divide effects by negotiation. Both parties deprecated war, but one would make war rather than let the nation survive, and the other would accept war rather than let it perish, and the war came. 1/8 of the whole population were colored slaves. These slaves constituted a peculiar and powerful interest. All knew that this interest was somehow the cause of the war. To strengthen, perpetuate, and extend this interest was the object which the insurgents would render even by war. While the government claimed no right to do more than restrict the territory of one another, neither party expected from the war the magnitude or duration which it has already achieved. Neither anticipated that the cause of the conflict might cease with or even before the conflict itself should cease. Each looked for a meaning of triumph, the result less fundamental than established. Both created the same Bible, and each invokes a date against the other. But let us trust not that we do not judge. The Almighty has his own purposes. Woe to the world because of offenses, for must needs that offenses come. But woe to the man by whom the offenses come. If we shall suppose that American slavery is one of those offenses, which, in the providence of God, must needs come, but, having continued through his appointed time, he now wills to remove, and that he gives to both North and South this terrible war as the woe due to those by whom the offense came. Shall we discern therein any departure from those divine attributes which the believers in a living God always ascribe to him? And that fervently do we pray that this mighty scourge of war may speedily pass away. Yet if God wills that it continue until all the wealth held by the bondsmen, 250 years of unrequited toil shall be sunk, and until every drop of blood drawn with the lash shall be paid by another drawn with the sword. As it was said 3,000 years ago, so still must be said, the judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. With malice towards none, with charity for all, with firmness in the right, as God gives us the will to see the right, let us strive to finish the work we are in, to bind the nation's goods, and to care for him who shall have borne the battle, and for his widow and his orphan, to do all which we